Happy Monday. Happy Blessing Day. Today is Blessing Day. Today's the day we call for the blessing. People call me on Monday and they say, Pastor Jim, I want my weekly blessing. Make sure you get your weekly blessing. Amen. People, my phone will ring all day long. People calling and wanting the weekly blessing. If you don't get through when you call, call back. Amen. Or I'll call you back. But I want to make sure I talk to everybody today. And believe me, I will talk to, you can't imagine how many phone calls will come through today. Because I want to bless everybody. I want all of our partners to be blessed today. Amen. I will get to them. Some of them will call tomorrow. Some of them will call Wednesday. Some of them call Thursday. But we want to make sure you get blessed every week. Every week, especially when you do your offerings and donations. A lot of people do them on Monday. When you do your, if you do your offerings and donations today, especially call me because I want to speak the blessing over you. Hey, I want to talk to you today about how to get a prayer boost that works every time. How to pray. Comes from this book, How to Pray. If you don't have this book, get it. Please. Get this book, How to Pray. Because I want everybody to be able to, wouldn't it be nice if you could just pray and get your prayer answered? You can. Because you can get a boost for your prayer. This, I don't know why, nobody else has ever seen this out here. I've never heard anybody else talk about it. Never heard anybody else to ever talk. You know what? The lack of knowledge about prayer, to me, is incredible. I wrote this small book on prayer. And you know what this book does? It will show you so many different ways of actually getting your prayers answered. Yet, people pray their whole lives and never get prayers answered. They just pray. Good friend of mine, somebody that I've had a relationship with over the years, is a prayer warrior. Oh, Pastor Jimmy says, come pray with us on the beach. We're going to pray at 5 o'clock in the morning on the beach. As far as I know, this person, I don't know if he's ever had a prayer answered, but he prays. And he prays. And he prays for this, and he prays for that. And a prayer life is wonderful. I don't pray like that, folks. But I praise God a lot. All the time. All day long. Mary sings in the Spirit all the time. Praises. Mary praises. She lives a life of praise. She praises all day long. Every day. She always says, I think she praises God in her sleep, if you want to know the truth. That's how much she loves the Lord. She just praises God all the time. And I do too. I don't know that I praise God as much as she does, but we do. We praise the Lord a lot. But as for actual praying, I don't do a whole lot of it. But I get prayers answered. Why is that? Because I know how to boost prayers. I know how to boost prayers. I'm going to show you. It's right in the Bible. It's so simple. I don't know why nobody else has ever seen it. But I did. And it works. How many of you know that God's word works? Say this with me. The rest of my life is the best of my life. The best of my life is the rest of my life. Everything I touch turns to gold. I am smart and getting smarter every day. I am extremely talented. People like me. I'm a wonderful person. Pastor Jim is a wonderful pastor. Actually, Pastor Jim is the best preacher in the whole country. With the certificate to prove it. Let's start off the week with the certificates. And the best prayer partner. Do you know what the best prayer partner can do? The best prayer partner can get your prayers answered for you. That's what a really good prayer partner, not somebody that's just, well, let's just pray. And then two people just pray and pray and pray and pray. No, I get them answered. That's the big difference. I'm not bragging. I'm just saying I can do this. Everybody should be able to. Every pastor should be able to get prayers answered for the people in their church. What's so hard about that? Well, because they don't know how to do it. Read the book. Read the book, folks. I'm telling you, when you get to heaven and the Lord starts to explain some of this to you, stuff to you, he's going to say, well, it's right there in the Word. Why didn't you see it? Why didn't you do it? I'm trying to do what... If I find it in the Word, I'm going to do it, folks. Let me tell you, if I find it, and I do find a lot, because the Lord shows me. I ask the Lord every day for revelation knowledge. Lord, give me the spirit of wisdom today, revelation knowledge, and favor in the name of Jesus. Go to our website, increasenow.com. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Tell everybody you know about these videos. Now, I'm going to show you something right here and right now that's just going to light you up. Hannah, how many of you know that Eli, in 1 Samuel chapter 1, the priest, is the model all pastors should try to be like? This is the guy. This is the pastor. He's the pastor. And why? Because he knows how to get prayers answered. Can your pastor get a prayer answered for you? The minister that you support, can he get a prayer answered for you? Can your prayer partner get a prayer answered for you? Eli could. He could. Why? Because he knew how to do it. Now, how simple is that? Eli knew how to get prayers answered. And guess what? So do I. Now, I was doing this years ago before I ever saw the story of Eli. The Lord has always showed me how to do things. Always showed me how to do things. The Lord showed me how to get the blessing of the Lord to come upon me. And then I found out and saw and heard Kenneth Copeland talk about the fact that he had done it the same way. But the Lord showed me before I ever saw him how he did it. Because I didn't know that he had done it that way. And he never mentions it because he doesn't have a revelation of it. But I do. That's why we get so many people blessed. That's why we get the blessing of the Lord to come on so many people. Because not only did I do it, but I know how to do it. And I can do it not just for myself and for my family, but for other people too. Back to Eli. Our model pastor. The guy who will give your prayer a boost. He was the original, as far as I know, prayer booster. The original prayer booster. Hannah was in the temple. She was past age of childbearing. She had no children. Her husband, I'm sure, was 20 or 30 years older than she was. Had he died and left her without a son, she would have been in the streets because she would have had no means of support. That's what happened to women in those days if they died without a son, or if their husband died without and didn't leave them a son. They were in the streets. And so she was in the temple crying and travailing and pouring her heart out before the Lord. And Eli, the priest, comes along and he says, have you been drinking? Because she was so upset. She was so upset And she said, no, no. She says, I have poured out my soul before the Lord. That's all she said to him. And look what Eli does. Just look at this. He says, in verse 17 of 1 Samuel chapter 1, he says, go in peace, and the God of Israel grant you your petition that you have asked. That God of Israel give you what you want. That's all he said. And he walked away. And she lit up like a light bulb. Because she knew that was the end of it. She knew that God was going to answer her prayer. She knew she was going to have a child. Her countenance changed. She wasn't sad anymore. She hadn't even been able to eat. If you think you're going to be out on the streets, folks, believe me, food is the last thing on your mind. Now she's hungry. She goes and eats. Her and her husband did their sacrifice, got blessed, went home, and she conceived a child in her old age and had a son and named him Samuel. And then Eli blessed her again. She went home and had five more kids. She had six children. Why? Because Eli said so. No other reason. Look at this. Go in peace, he says. The God of Israel give you what you want. This is how I boost prayers. People say, oh, Pastor Jim, I need a job. I need a job. I say, the Lord will give you a job. They get great jobs. Pastor Jim, I need money to make my car payment. I say, the Lord will give you money to make your car payment. The money comes in. Pastor Jim, I'm sick. I say, be healed. In Jesus' name. Their body heals. People get off their deathbeds because I tell them to. I'm just doing what Eli did. I'm doing the same thing. I just do it like Eli did. Why aren't people paying attention to Eli? He boosted Hannah's prayer. Hannah had been praying for years to have a baby. Probably 20 years she had been praying to have a baby. Now she's too old. One boost from Eli, and she conceived. Can you see this? Read 1 Samuel chapter 1, please. And you'll know how I do this. I have that kind of faith to do that, folks. I always have. It's a gift, maybe. I don't know. I don't know where it comes from. It's just there. God gives people a measure of faith. But we grow our faith too. Hey, I'm out of time. You need your prayer boosted? Call me today, especially on Blessing Day. Amen. I'll get your prayer boosted. Amen. I mean, we've gotten people great jobs, great positions, favor in court. Somebody was losing their driver's license. I said, you will not lose your driver's license. You have favor. They didn't lose it. People go to court, all kinds of stuff. I say, you have favor. They win. Every time. Go to my website, increasenow.com. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. You know, what I do is not that extraordinary, folks. Everybody should be doing this. Every pastor should be doing this. If your pastor isn't doing it, you should ask him why. Tell him to read 1 Samuel chapter 1. When you do your offerings and donations today, make sure you call me. I am out of time. I'm determined you're going to live a curse-free, blessed life.